Hello there everyone, CyanMark3 and welcome back to the Barren Desert, which is the vehicle designer. Or rather, welcome back to Ashes of the Empire campaign. No, this is not an intermission video, I'm just here in the designer to start out because there are some things I need to poke around with before going to the campaign proper. And I think I'm going to be doing more of my building here in the designer, to be quite honest. When I was building stuff in the campaign, it was just like, hey, you're building this, by the way, here, have an enemy, we're going to fight you now. So, I'm going to try avoiding that a little bit. And hopefully it'll feel a bit better, go a bit smoother, I don't know. It'll certainly be better without the interruptions all the time, like, oh, am I going to get attacked now? Yes, no, maybe. Flipping enemy computers decided to try and kill me. It's an annoying habit they've got, I know, and I've done much to deserve it, but I'd rather they weren't doing it quite as much as they do. Anyway, moving on. For what I'm poking around with right now, I want to call in a hoverbug. Hunter drone might be able to do it, but hoverbug... It's a stable little platform, so that's what I want, really. There we go. A stable little platform, which is already built, so it can get me up in the air, so I can test this out. Except it's not going anywhere. Why is it? Oh yeah, this thing doesn't actually have its own power source. Anyway, yeah, this hoverbug is something I built for a Netta campaign. Not actually one I recorded, so it's never been seen online or in a video before. And basically what this is a drone. It's supposed to charge itself up at a main base and then just wander off wherever I decided I wanted to go and fight things like the Deepwater Guard, a few expansion ships, things like that, until its battery starts to run down, then come back and recharge itself. So that's really what this thing is meant to do and why it has no kind of onboard power source. It was also built before the RTGs got their enlarged version, so that's why it doesn't really have those. So yes. Anyway, what I want from this thing here is I just want its stability. So that means I can tear out that, so sever the turret. It was just a simple advanced cannon anyway. This thing was never a very powerful combatant. It never had to be. But what this thing is... Actually, I don't need the local weapon controller anyway, so get rid of that. Okay. Now, let's get up with this. Actually, I could probably spawn this thing straight into the campaign anyway. I mean, it's pretty small. It's just not very powerful, so it would need an upgrade. Anyway, what I'm testing here is something from Sorority, once again. And that is the suggestion of a... What was it termed as? A zero thingamy thingamy thingamajig. Yes, that's specific, isn't it? Anyway, it's a rail bomber kind of thing. Again, being very, very specific here. Yes, I know that all this technical information, it's like, it's too much, isn't it? I swear, I will do a bit better. But anyway, I think that was group one anyway, so just hit that. The principle is this. You want a shell which has no actual requirement for, you know, words. Words, my old nemesis. How I hate thee. Yeah, anyway. The idea is that you have a shell which has no propellant or anything like that on it, so it just kicks out and doesn't do a thing as far as cooldown is concerned. So the entire thing will eject all of its shells very, very quickly. So it'll kick them all out. It's like, hooray, all at once, and then it's just pointing downwards, so it spews a massive shedload of bombs in one go. That's the general principle. I know there's much better ways to explain it, but hey, this is me we're talking about here. Me give good explanations? No, not at all. So yeah, I'm just going to rig this up and get it like I so delicately explained, and I'll be back in a few moments once I've got this thing ready for testing. Okay, I think I've got this thing rigged up how it's meant to be. I've quickly modified the hoverbug with the PID pitch stability system, because honestly this craft was never quite the most stable craft around, but you know, just to make sure it stays flat. And underneath I've just rigged it up with a very quick knock-up cannon kind of thing, which should work. What would help is, for this testing at least, a fall of shot predictor would be pretty darn nice. Is that attached? I think like that. Okay, yeah. Since they've got no propellant on them, these things are not going to be any good. Anyway, it's like on the cookie wagon with the cram bombs. This is a advanced cannon version kind of thing. Anyway. Interesting. Okay. Right. Now, next test, set a fire rate limit of 150. See what that does to it. This might actually be quite viable. Need bigger bombs, though. Confession time, I did actually rig this thing with 500mm when I first put it together, and then I just thought, no, this is for test firing, let's just strip that out and set it down to whatever it is now. But I did clear the armor space for it, so let's go ahead and upgrade this thing to a 500mm. There we go, that should be enough. Yep, 500mm, let it load up and see what it can do. To be quite honest, without the propellant, this thing can barely aim itself, so that's a thing. And also because it wouldn't be good testing without something to, you know, test on, I've spawned in a mantis down below. I forgot how high this thing is set to fly, actually, so, you know. Anyway, chocks away and all that. There go the bombs. Let's see. I increased the RPM as well, by the way. Oh! Interesting. Okay. Maybe a bit too fast on the firing rate there, but, yeah. Just give it a chance to reload again. It's going to take a while because of the 500mm on it. But, yeah, this looks promising. Shame about the lack of versatility for the firing range, though. Let's bring it around a bit. I better unhitch the camera, actually, as well. Because I forgot, this thing, when it turns, it wobbles so much since it's such a narrow design. Anyway, can the cannons please load? Thank you. And it needs to turn again. It definitely needs the high fire rate. Oof. What is it even doing? Oh, whoop! Apparently I have thruster control. Whoops. I didn't mean to do that. Hang on. I need to land this thing up for another shot. It really doesn't have very good aim control. Have to stop turning as well. Oh dear. Maybe this design isn't as stable as I used to think. Okay, that's lined up. Sort of. What are you going to do to this mantis now, then? Oh! Ouch! Wow. 112,000 damage. Sorty, I like this idea. It does need a bit of work. 800 RPM, though, does seem to be quite useful. Wow. That mantis is getting wrecked by this thing. Might not be too good against the flayers, though, I must admit that. Also needs a dedicated platform to it, but this thing is actually pretty nice. Are you going to reload anytime soon? Come on, you're almost perfectly lined up. I need you to reload. Yeah, might benefit from a slightly lower fire rate, but yeah. And it missed completely. Also, low altitude would probably also be a good idea, I think. But that mantis has definitely got nothing about this. I think this idea bears investigation. It's actually pretty darn nice. Yeah, definitely need to do something with this. I like this. It's bombs. Bombing, but fast. Unless you count the shell speed, in which case it's actually pretty darn slow, but you know, you get the idea. Okay, for a very quick test, I've just rigged up the Hoverbug's AI to this bomb dropper thing. And I've spawned in a Ravager with its AI turned off, so it won't be trying to shoot me down since I'm highly vulnerable. And let's go ahead and see what the AI makes of this. Full control, if you please. Oh, there go the missiles. Okay. Not what I'm interested in, though. I want to see what it does with the cannon. I've also messed with the AI, so it'll try to get as close as possible. What the heck is it doing? Oh yeah, it's a limited firing arc problem. It's trying to get somewhere. Ah, that's the problem. There we go. That'll tell it's getting broadside now, because it's actually hovers pretty darn high. Or it should do. What's going on? You should not be having these issues, mister. You really should not. Ah, man. If it doesn't fire this time, Look, I'm having some problems with this weapon system, okay? To be quite honest. Yeah? Nice. Oh, finally! Wait, no, that... that... well, that was, Right, okay. Slight issue with the weapon system. What I've worked out is... this thing, because it has no flipping propellant in the shells, it has decided that it doesn't have a viable weapon on it, so it can't fire it. Let's increase the range to 75, I guess. So what I've done is I've dropped the firing range. Wait, no, I dropped the firing rate. And I've rigged up an ACB to tell it when there's an enemy within range, so it can start unloading its bombs and hopefully causing some damage. I've also significantly dropped the altitude of the craft as well, so that it can actually hopefully do something about it. But for some reason, I think because it doesn't have any weapon system, the AI is also acting up. Well, weapon system is considered valid. So I definitely need some help with this thing if anyone's got any advice for me and stuff like that. Because it's, oh, that's looking better. Ooh. Oh, bang. Sure. yeah. I can definitely do something with this weapon system, but it is flawed. Flawed like hell, in my iteration and understanding of it. So... yeah, some feedback and help on this would be appreciated, because I don't really think I can get it viably functioning as it is now. I mean, I wouldn't trust it as it is now. Let's drop this down to 55, okay. And increase the firing rate to double, 600... actually, no, let's increase that to 60. This seems very unreliable to me, but I could probably make a weapon system out of it. Also, I need some feedback on how to control a... how to make a plane AI, an aerial AI. Okay, it's releasing them too soon. And because I'm trying to work out the flipping timing on this thing, that means I have to tune this for every individual craft that's actually using it. So, yeah, this is not great at all. I mean, if the craft is moving slow, then the bombs need to be released at a different time, and it's not really... yeah, I need help with this darn thing. To put it bluntly. And, oh, the bombs weren't reloaded. Oh! Press the wrong key. Bang. Fine. Yeah. This test is not going very well, is it? Also, how much of the spare episodes have I actually used upon this testing and trying to... I think that's going to miss. Yep, that missed badly. Yeah. Further development definitely required. Anyway, let's cut that there. I've been messing around for about 15 minutes or so trying to get this darn thing to work. So, yeah, I need help with this thing. Definitely. Flip it. Maybe I should use the hoverbug as an interim aircraft. But, I don't know. I mean, the unmodified one. Or at least not modified with this weapon system. Because, you know, this weapon system is not doing too well at all. Anyway! Nope. Bang. Nope. Completely messed up now. Yeah. Back to the campaign, where I can actually do some actual damage. That would be nice, wouldn't it? Yeah. Okay, welcome back to the campaign, where at the end of last time we ran into this air fleet which seems to be built of ground vehicles, so not sure what's going on there. Anyway, let's get this fight on the road, so we can do something destructive with this episode, since the construction bit was a bit of a mess. Yeah. Anyway, this is all ground stuff, yeah, so let's go ahead and let the maggots have some fun. So we'll find them in all this. Yep. Okay, here we go. Let's actually space the maggots out a bit. There was a comment suggesting that I put spinning rotors on the maggots to help them do things, but I've not managed to do that yet. Not had a chance to. So, yay, I'm kind of behind. What else is new? Sure. Let's put the ASB over there. And let's spawn into this mantis. Nope, that mantis. Yes, thank you. Okay, let's just go ahead and get this fight rolling. As soon as everything's spawned in, at least. Make sure. All terrain. Yep, okay. And begin. Here we go. Ooh, that was a bit laggy to start, wasn't it? Oh, I'm actually going to control the weapon system. Okay. Maggots charging in. Gravram rounds? No, I didn't see any shells coming in. Oh, well, the Gatlings are going out. Yep. The maggots are making an absolute nuisance of themselves. Good to see. Gatling tanks are trying to punch through. Mostly failing. Yeah, there was another suggestion from Svorty, which I'm going to take advantage of here. Ooh, what was that? I think that was one of the maggots going up. Why the heck are you pointing backwards, silly thing? Yep, Gravram rounds are definitely in effect. That's why I put some fair armor underneath these tanks. Because I knew they'd get flipped up at some point or other. Oh yeah, speaking of Svorty again, they've been having some good fun with my designs, actually. They've refitted part of the Scorpion and the Railgun Mantis. So I'm planning to have a look at that, see how I can improve and what notes I can take to make them better. Oh yeah, look at that Gatling, it's just... Yep, that thing's not happy at all. Without the shields, I can actually do a lot of damage really fast with those things. But yeah, I'm planning to look at that, I've just not had a chance to yet. So, Svorty, glad you're having fun with the stuff. Keep it up. Hey. Another note from Svorty is refitting one of these Gatling Mantis tanks with... Oh, that's torn the back end straight off, that one. Is to refit one of these things with heat rounds to help it crack through enemy shields. And that is actually a good idea. I've never really used heat rounds that much, but... Hello, flying maggots in the background over there. Hope you're enjoying yourself. These enemies are mostly dead now, aren't they? Let's check. Oh no, there's still a whole bunch of them waiting to spawn. Mm. But yeah, I'll refit one of the Manti with better rounds. Well, a different kind of round, at least. And oh dear, there's two Scorpions actually rolling around, so the enemy's going to be enjoying that. Anyway, let's skip ahead and let things keep on going. While I quickly modify this mantis here, since it's conveniently located, I'll just give this thing heat rounds. Actually, I might as well keep the recording rolling while I do that. Something explodes very messily in the background. Anyway, let's get in here. Here we go. Now then, I built these Gatlings around a very specific cooldown. So, I don't really want to mess around with the power of the charges too much, because they're also built specifically for size as well. Let's see if I can make a decent heat round out of this thing as is. Let's see, shape charge head. That's the one. And then that uses immediate connected explosives, so this is going to slow the shell down anyway. But how is this going to do if I set it to the 150, which is what it is? 150, not 8. Key. Okay. Shape charge head, penetration factor. Balance between volume of copper. Okay, penetration death. High has huge penetration distances, which can damage or destroy particular blocks. But yo, yields a spalling. This thing needs to punch through after hitting a shield, not widen out, so. Heat penetration? Oh, wow, that's. Heat particle count. Oh, I see what Swarty meant. Alright, okay. So that'll penetrate better, but it will not generate as many of those, so. 12 if this value is 4, then the armor. And the armor is armor class 4, then we can penetrate through 2 meters of that armor. So, armor class 10, that's metal. That'll over penetrate against most of these guys. Actually, 9.3, that's looking pretty good. 9, I mean, the stuff I'm facing is armor rating 7, so. 11 just to be on the safe side. So that's about mid-range, that should be okay, and I don't... 3 powder charges, so let's increase the... Oh, while I was doing that, battle finish. Hooray! Okay, I won. Look at me. 7, blast radius 4... I don't know what half of this stuff is relevant anymore. I mean, is that... I need to read up on this. Shape charge head. No arm piercing, but users connected. Shell health. Speed modifier. Okay, looks all pretty standard. Penetration factor is the key thing. Actually, adding the extra HE slowed the shell down. Gave it less range, but increased the penetration. So 12, 7, that's going to punch through a lot of stuff, but 7 means it's going to cause some serious damage as well. So yeah, let's go with that then. That's what this mantis is going to carry. Sure. Also, let's go ahead and grab the coloration on this tank, because I want something to differentiate. Damn it! And I was doing so well too. Okay. To differentiate it, I want to give it a nice orange instead of a blue. There we go. Okay, so we can now tell it apart at a glance. The orange one has the lovely explosive rounds, while the blue one still has the regular armor piercing. So yes, there we go. We can tell at a glance. Sure. Now I just need to make sure this darn thing's loaded properly. And to do that, I found a good way to do it is to go into the weapon system to force it to reset its ammunition by changing its shell volume. Shell gauge. So if I reduce the shell gauge, it'll be forced to reload all its ammunition and discard all of the shells that it had before. And then I can just change it straight back. He says while fumbling around with the interface. I'm 150. There we go. Okay, now that'll load up everything from scratch properly, and it'll all be the new piercing munitions. Excellent. Now we just need to test this darn thing, and also get it loaded as well. Yep. Right. Okay. Did I actually lose anything in that fight? Yeah, I lost some maggots. Okay. Actually, while I'm at this, really quick, let's go to this other comment. Didn't come from Svorty, by the way, so nope. It did not. Pull everything. Play this tank because I need to do some quick modifications to it. Flipping camera. Right, okay. And it says I have no resources. Why not? Doesn't this have any resources? No! Oh! Oh dear. That's not good. Apparently I burned more resources from that fight than I actually got back in salvage. I forgot about that. My resource return is actually pretty darn low, so... Also, it just took a whole bunch of it repairing the maggots too. Let's actually go ahead and scrap this maggot. So that's given me some immediate resources to help finish patching things up. Yes, we've lost a maggot. I am sorry, but they weren't... they were amusing, but they were not that effective. Anyway, moving on. Sorry about the wobbling, but this is how this thing operates after all. Now, to do this modification, I think I need to tear this out here. Like that, and then I need to clear some space as well, so that's a little bit back here, back here. Oh, this is doing all sorts of things to this thing, isn't it? Mm. Yeah, okay. Now, the suggestion was this, that I use spinning blocks and things to add new object, add a new spin slash turn block, and then use this so the maggots will do continuous damage on impact rather than, you know, comically flailing around like they have been doing. So let's go ahead and get this thing sorted out. It's going to be a ram, yep. Mirror mode it. Like that, so that's okay. Right. Get back onto the main vehicle because it needs to have some more stuff like that. Yeah. And then it's same on the other side. Right, okay. So it's going to be on here. Right. So the idea here is that this thing is going to hit, charge in and hit like it normally does. And then it's going to be able to keep on going, so it'll keep on chewing through rather than just like doing what it has been doing and stopping and charging. Ugh. Words. Words. I know has them. Look. It's supposed to do continuous damage rather than failing as it has been. Okay? Leave it at that. Now, of course, this requires an ACB as well. And look, I've torn a whole chunk of protection out. So, yeah. This thing's armor back, but... What's my control block? I'll put it there. Right. Every second. Then set the spin blocks. Rotation speed to 5 so I can just see which one's going which way. Okay. So that's how they're going. Then if I put this... hang on. Okay, this is the one I want to go the other way, so reverse it. So there we go. This thing is trying to claw its way into what it hits. Like that. But these things do more damage the faster they go, so I'm going to change this up to maximum possible speed, 3-0. So there we go, that is a great and powerful new thing. Okay, this thing needs to be tested as well. I just need to get armor back into place, so BRB. See you in a few moments. Man, this is an ugly looking one now, isn't it? Well, wish and ye shall receive. I was just thinking that I need something to test out the newly configured Gatling and the newly configured Maggots against, which is this one here. Let's change the rushing maggots to the gnawing maggot. So I can tell them apart, you know. There we go. Now, I'm moving my fleet in to intercept against this force here, which is Ravagers, a Stinger. Ooh, I've not seen many air units, actually. Cataphracts, mostly Ravagers, though. And this will be the test of the gnawing maggot. Temporary name, by the way. Yes, I do want to go into that fight. And the high explosive Gatling. So, sure, let's go ahead and get this set up and see what they can do. Thank you. Okay, now then, the gnawing maggots needs to be up front and personal ahead of the maggots. I didn't rename the mantis, so I don't know which one is which. It's a slight issue. It's over there. Gatling over there, let's put Gatling over here, let's put the rushing maggot on the flank like that, ready to go charging straight in. The other two maggots are over here, and the rest, they're spread out okay where they are. Okay, yep. Okay, let's go in there and test this. First, make sure everything's spawned in. It was not, so good thing I checked. Is that everything? Yep, that is everything. Okay. Let's see what this does. Help if I press the back key, wouldn't it? Begin! Charge! Show me what you're made of, maggots! And please try not to break, because I know you're a flipping prototype. Oh, the other two maggots were charging in first. Okay, fine. Well, to be fair, this modified maggot is actually slightly slower than the regular one, so that is a thing as well. That is the regular one. The yellow shells are coming from the high explosive one. Here it comes. And... oh! Oh dear! That is a bit of an improvement. Definitely an improvement. It kind of chewed its way in, but then it stopped. Ow. And I got killed by something. I think it was my high explosive tank, actually. Yeah, I think it was my heat Gatling, which just killed me. It punched straight through. Anyway. Oh well, what's a little testing without a slight risk of death, eh? Plus this is one spectacular pile-up as well. Look at all this stuff. Oh, there goes the maggot. There goes a maggot, there goes something. One slight drawback of the heat equipped Gatling. Its shells are now a lot slower, so not as good against something that's flying around. I knew that though, they did seem to be doing a fair bit, so yeah. This isn't the best test though. The gnawing maggot is trying to get itself rolling. I'm not even sure what it's trying to do anymore. That enemy's dead. Oh, it's picked up on something else, I think. Wait, where are you going? There's an enemy there. There's an enemy there, but that's dead. There's more enemies spawning. Oh! It's trying, bless it. But I think I'm out of resources again. Yeah. Okay. I think the target prioritization is messing up a bit as well, because this is not quite right at all. Maggot, what are you doing? Turn this way, you idiot. Because there's an enemy over there you can stick your teeth into. That way. Over there, come on. Good maggot. Good maggot. What are you even doing? Oh, you're finally going after the right guy. Okay, sure. There's something in the air over there. Not entirely sure what that is, but still. Oh, there's particle cannons involved. Nope. Oh dear. The high explosive mantis just exploded. Now that's a bit of irony. Here comes the maggots, and... I think a better configuration would have been a rolling bar rather than twin side scoops, because this maggot seems to be suffering from the same kind of drawback the original one does, which is the fact that the sloped blocks aren't sloped. So they collide like they're a flat block, and yeah. I think that is one of the main problems, actually. So it's still in need of a bit of redesign, this. Oh, come on, that way. Forward! Yeah. Also, spin blocks are kind of fragile. So so I kind of snapped them straight off, and my scorpion just killed my mantis. Damn it all. That's not going too well. There's still not something which stops allied tanks from shooting other tanks. I wish there was. Because it makes swarming things like this a bit harder to be... Yeah, there goes an entire flipping mantis. This charge is losing momentum pretty fast. Because that's an expensive loss. Oh. And I think I'm about to lose the gnawing mantis as well, because that... The gnawing mantis? Now that's a scary thought. Oh. Something exploded. Oh, something spawned over there and probably got shot. Of course. Where are they going? So, yeah, I think I've got... Maybe I should try to focus more on having better vehicles, because having so many is just causing chaos for the most part. Hello, maggot. Oh, hello, enemy. Already losing blocks to the scorpions, I see. Good for you. Also, tons of missiles coming in from the Scarab forces. Yeah, I don't think that tank's going to be very long for this world, to be quite honest with you. Maybe I need a better cheap battle tank. Scarabs are fairly good for what they are, but... Might be time for a new generation. Might be time for a new cheap battle tank, using what I've learned so far. I don't know. Here comes a maggot, but it's... Doesn't seem too sure about what it's doing. There we go. Battle finished! That was a complete fusterclock. Yes, fusterclock. Because I suspect I took some heavy losses. Let's see, I lost the gnawing maggots. I lost the heat mantis. I lost another maggot. Other than that, I'm pretty much okay, but... The mantis in particular hurts, because that was an expensive one. And ironically, both of the test vehicles I just rigged up both got killed. Yeah. So that is also a thing. I need to pull back and resupply. But yeah, that is also it for this episode, because I spent a while trying to get a rail bomber working. Failed quite miserably. Though I am intrigued by the concept and I want to try and get something like that functional. And then I came out and got some fighting and testing done, so all in all, a good video, I think. Or at least I've made some progress. Though I am now retreating with my tail between my legs, so maybe not that much progress. I don't know. Anyway, I'm starting to babble. This has been Iron Mark 3. Thank you very much for watching. If you have any feedback or help, that would be appreciated, as I try to work out what was going on with the craft earlier. Like I mentioned, I need to help a bit of help working out what to do with the rail bomber design, or if it's just going to have to be ACB controlled. Also, thrustercraft using with an aerial AI would be nice to have, because I don't know, the AI on that thing, hoverbug, was being extremely unresponsive, so not sure what's going on there. In general, just advice. Please help me, please. I'm begging. Well, not begging, no. Just trying to be amusing and failing. Anyway, yeah. I really am babbling, aren't I? This has been Iron Mark 3. Thank you very much for watching. This time, for realsies, this is the actual real ending of the video. And I hope you enjoyed the show. I've lost my flow again. Darn it. I hope you enjoyed the show, and I'll catch you some other time. I'll see you later. Yes, that was it. I forgot the order for a moment there. Ah. Don't distract me when I'm doing things. It makes me a bit scatterbrained of late. I've noticed. Oh god, I'm babbling again, aren't I? Oh no. Yep, end of video. Thank you. Bye bye.